He played a gangland boss in Underbelly, and perhaps he's found it difficult to take the law seriously since. Actor Vince Colosimo facing court today over 170 unpaid fines.
I don't know who you think you're talking to, mate, but you're being very rude, do you understand? Show me some respect, will you? Very, very rude.
Vince Colosimo is used to the cameras. Not today, doing everything he could to avoid them. Instead of showing up to the Melbourne Magistrates Court, the Wog Boy star was at his lawyer's office, logging in from behind a computer screen to face the music.
I would like to take this opportunity to declare my total and absolute innocence in the matter.
The Underbelly star tonight, a free man, his $62,000 haul of unpaid fines wiped by a magistrate because Colosimo had evidence that he suffers from a profound mental illness and said he's struggling financially.
There's no cash here. Here, there's no cash.
The sorry saga began late last year when Colosimo admitted in court to drug driving for the second time and masquerading as his twin brother when pulled over by police. Then, a plot twist. Prosecutors revealing the star owes tens of thousands in unpaid fines, calling for him to be jailed instead of getting more fines. The magistrate fined him anyway, $2,500, admitting she had little confidence he'd actually pay.
Hey, it was business, right? The fat slob owed me money.
Well, how much?
Doesn't matter how much. It's the principle, right?
So the sheriff hauled Colosimo to court over 169 outstanding infringements, totaling nearly $62,000. But his lawyer applied to have that debt wiped because of Colosimo's mental health, a ground that can be used to get out of paying the debt.
Mr. Colosimo's been quite lucky to get the reduction of the debt.
The unpaid fines including speeding tickets, driving unregistered on toll roads, disobeying traffic lights, even failing to vote. In the end, $58,000 in total was wiped, the remaining almost $9,000 converted to community work, totaling 101 hours over a year.
It sends a message that finally the courts and, more importantly, Parliament has a bit more empathy with people who end up in this sort of situation and are able to give them a break and offer them a way out.
Sean Hardy is a leading traffic and infringements barrister.
If reduction of the debt is not allowed and the community work hours become excessive or jail time becomes excessive, then the court pretty much has an obligation to intervene and make sure that the case is dealt with more fairly.
It's the latest scene in a troubled few years for Colosimo, whose on-screen drama has followed him off-set in a role he never wanted to play.
And if Vince doesn't complete his community service, he's been warned he could go to jail.